Need me live for a conversation from Kajiado. Quick conversation on the International Day of the Girl Child is Nice Nailantei Lengete. She's a founder of Nice Place Foundation and also an anti-FGM activist. Nice, thanks for making time for us. So today marks the International Day of the Girl Child. What is your assessment of the war against FGM and SGBV and even early childhood marriage this far?
Thank you, Trevor. And, you know, efforts and intentions are encouraging both within the communities and government, but there is still a long way to go. Comparing the environment when I was supposed to face the cut when I was young and now, we did not have the laws that we have now. Girls, you know, now have access to information and telecommunication and platforms to report issues of female genital mutilation and gender-based violence. So I will say there is more awareness now among the population, and all these factors make a difference for the current girls. But now with the COVID-19 pandemic, remember also girls have been faced with new challenges as they had to go away from school for more than 1 year. And I think for the first night right now, we have seen issues of female genital mutilation and child marriage on the rise more than ever before.
Yeah.
But I must also say that, you know, Kenya has made really great steps on the fight.
Yeah. As a survivor yourself, what more would you like to see happening to address those issues effectively, Nice? Because you just said things are a bit different from the time you were supposed to face the cut. But what more would you like to see going forward?
What I want to see more is really a community being empowered more to speak about it. Because remember, change has to start from within. And as I said earlier on that video, is that we have the law, which is very important. But the community has to be sensitized. Our fathers, our mothers, you know, our brothers, they need to understand why are we saying that female genital mutilation is not only affecting the health of the girl, but it's also affecting the education, it's taking their dreams away and all that. So what I also want to see is that, remember, for the circumcisers, that is a job for them. How do we also ensure that we have alternative sources of income for the women? We don't just empower them with information, but we also make sure that they have other sources of making money to support their families. So the other thing is also to empower girls to be able to speak up, the girls who are at risk, but more important is to have investments in education. Without education or without investment in education, we will not be able to end any form of gender-based violence.
Yeah, Nice. As we wind up, are you seeing a concerted effort when it comes to fighting SGBV, FGM, and early childhood marriage? Because I read your speech earlier on today, and you're saying that taking action is not a choice, it's our duty. What exactly did you mean by that?
What I meant is that, you know, it's a duty because every Kenyan is directly affected by the terrible practice. All resources we lose by not achieving the full potential of a woman is a direct cost to every Kenyan. And we also must speak for those who cannot speak. And that is why now we've been able to open up a Nice Place, which is a leadership academy and a safe home for girls. We still have girls who are still at risk of undergoing female genital mutilation and child marriage. We didn't have a place to keep them. Now we have, as we make sure that they are also able to continue with their education.
How many have you been able to rescue?
Right now, you know, we just started a few weeks ago. Right now at the center, we have about 5 girls, but also for the Leadership Academy, we have enrolled about 48 girls.
All right. So what does the future look like as we wind up on this? Nice.
How the future looks like, because the motto in a Nice Place is to dream, learn, and lead. So we want to ensure that our girls can be anything they aspire to be. This is the place whereby we are calling a home of champions, whereby if you aspire to be a doctor or a teacher, we are able to support you to get where you are.
All right. Thanks, Nice. That's Nice Lengete. Speaking to us live from Kajiado there. She's the founder of a Nice Place Foundation and also an activist against FGM.